Brothers and sisters, children of the Most High God, those who are regular followers of my videos, you know that for 2 or 3 years, the Lord has been showing me the symbol of the Antichrist, or the biggest clue to who is Antichrist, is the Fleur-de-lis. And I've been trying to figure out what it means exactly, and I've traced it actually. One thing that it shows is about, it connects back to the founder of the Jesuits. And I've made videos before the Pope ever came in about that. But, you know, everything always has multiple meanings with God. But here is the meaning of the Fleur-de-lis, or the major meaning. There's probably more to it than this. This is what the Lord dropped on me tonight. Daniel chapter 7, it tells us about the little horn, the willful king, the Antichrist. There's a kingdom of 10 nations. Now we see in Revelation 2, there's 10 kings and all that. And in Daniel chapter 7, we see that. And then out of the 10 kings, 3 of those kingdoms, 3 of the 10 is uprooted, or they are uprooted. 3 are uprooted and then replaced by 1. That's the Antichrist, a little horn who speaks blasphemy. The willful king, the Antichrist. He is one little horn who replaces 3 kingdoms. So therefore, that's the Fleur-de-lis is the 3 crowns, or the 3 horns of authority of the Antichrist. Of course, it also represents, you know, there's Christians in the past who have tried to use the Fleur-de-lis to say the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You know, it's a symbol of New Orleans and the New Orleans Saints. They use that as a symbol. You know, it's been used by the Catholic Church and all that in times past. But, you know, there's always people with little, as they, you know, I used to be in the Army and I was a medic and, I was a paramedic and also an LPN. And the doctors used to say, you know, a little bit of knowledge is dangerous, you know, because a lot of times people who are paramedics or are nurses, you know, sometimes they try to be the doctor when they're not. And, you know, like I said, there's a doctor I used to say all the time, you know, a little bit of knowledge is dangerous. So there's people who will say, when I made a Fleur-de-lis video, they'll say, well, you know, that's a symbol for the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And that's been used by the Catholics for 500 years or whatever they said, you know, something like that. But what they don't know, if they would just do a simple little search of, as you know, to quote President Bush, the Google, they would find out that the Fleur-de-lis has been used for thousands and thousands and thousands of years, long before even the Christian era. The Christian era, it was used. There's you can find Fleur-de-lis in ancient Ur of the Chaldees, way all the way back, all the way to Tower of Babel. You can find Fleur-de-lis used by Native Americans when they drew pictures of the gods who came down, like the aliens. Look like aliens. If you see those petroglyphs and all these things, and hieroglyphs, petroglyphs, all this stuff that's been done all over the world, and places where there was, you know, the before Christianity came there, pre-Columbian America, as they call it, you'll see images of the gods looking like aliens with a Fleur-de-lis on top of their head. From all over the world, brothers and sisters. So this is a symbol that was introduced through the leaven of Catholicism into Christian circles, when it is an ancient symbol referring to something else, really the unholy trinity, Satan, the false prophet, and the Antichrist. And the Lord had given me another word that I've got to go back and remember, brothers and sisters. Someone had reminded me of a video in the comments of a video I'd made a couple years ago, or a year and a half ago, maybe 2 years ago. And the Lord had spoken to me something. I don't know if I'm going to say it or not. All in one video here. Let me think. You know, when the Pope was... I'll just say this. Because the Lord had me following this about the connection of the Fleur-de-lis leading to the founder of the Jesuits there in the Basque region of Spain and French border. As we were writing the book, Sister Rosemary here was editing the book. She was, you know, I can't remember what all I said in videos or what all I was, you know, chatting with her about as we were, she was, you know, helping me, you know, write down the book as the Lord was giving it to me and helping me, you know, in editing it for me. You know, during that time when the Pope got put in office, lightning struck the Vatican twice. The lightning struck the Vatican twice. And it seems to me that it is a sign of he is the second beast, because lightning is a representative of Satan. And Jesus said, behold, I saw lightning, you know, Satan fall from the sky as lightning. And then when the Pope was inaugurated, lightning struck the Vatican twice. And of course, the second beast The book of Revelation calls him the second beast and the false prophet. Both titles are used for the second beast. It seems to be that the second beast, of course, is a religious leader who causes people to worship the first beast, who gets his power from the dragon. That's your unholy trinity. The dragon, as the Bible interprets for us, all of these things, the Bible interprets itself. The dragon, that old serpent, the devil, Satan, Lucifer, the one that was in the garden, who tempted Eve, that is the dragon. Of course, the first beast is the Antichrist, who will be a world king, a world ruler, who is represented by that Fleur-de-lis as having three crowns. He will have three crowns, and he will come to world power after he reigns over three. After he reigns over three, he will unite, take the crown away from three kingdoms, and make it, and he will become the leader of three kingdoms, and then he will become the world leader. So just like King David, he was the king of Judah first, and then later on he became the king of all of Israel. So, you know, so the devil does everything in a type and a shadow. So just as I'm thinking about it now, you know, I mean, as an example, the North American Union is three kingdoms that could come together to make one. I mean, it's just an idea I would throw out there. I mean, if you think that already, of course, it could be some three Middle Eastern countries coming together under ISIS, and then later on rule the world through ISIS. We don't know, brothers and sisters. I don't know those things. I'm just putting out what the Lord has shown me. God bless you guys. I'll cut it off there, and may the Lord bless you and keep you. And like I said, I will be leaving here in North Carolina. I will be in Birmingham this week. I will be in Shreveport, Louisiana this week, and then I will be in Dallas the beginning of next week before I go to the Philippines. I have meetings scheduled with people on Monday and Tuesday night in Dallas, basically from 6 to 9 p.m. I can, you know, the more the merrier. So if you are wanting to see me in Dallas, I'll be near the Dallas-Fort Worth Airport. Contact me, I'll tell you where I'm at, and you can come meet me there. That's this coming Monday and Tuesday, the 2nd and 3rd of February. God bless you guys. See you soon.